It's pretty close.
It's another day. Children come and play with chocolate butter.
Chocolate butter.
The sun is out today. I'll say hello today to chocolate butter.
Chocolate butter.
I'll teach you how to read and write. Not sure I can ride a bike. We'll go through all the letters and sounds. Having lots of fun, playing around. It's another day. Children come and play with chocolate butter.
Chocolate butter.
The sun is out today. I'll say hello today to chocolate butter. Chocolate, chocolate butter.
2, 3. Chocolate, chocolate butter. Good morning, Mr. Magpie.
Hello and welcome to the race of the century. This is Chocolate Chocolate Button versus me, Lucy. We are very excited to have you here today with us in the garden in Streatham. It is a big, exciting day. I'm sure you can see we are doing our stretches to get ready for this race. Chocolate Chocolate Button, how are you feeling on this auspicious occasion?
Well, I am feeling very excited, I'm feeling fit, I'm feeling ready. I've been doing my PE with Joe Wicks every day. I've been doing my cosmic yoga. I think it's fair to say I am ready.
Okay, great. Well, that sounds really, really good. I can't wait to get started. Speaking of getting started, shall we get started? Yes, let's do it. Okay, fantastic. Let's go. Mr. Lee, can you please give us the on your marks, get set, go?
On your marks, get set, go.
Chocolate Chocolate Button, that was really, really fun. Did you enjoy it? You did? Oh my goodness me. Well, I'm afraid, I think it's time for phonics now. I know. Quick, let's go and get our stuff ready. Let's see if you can get your whiteboard and your whiteboard pen or your pencil and your paper ready by the time we get to zero. Ready? 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and zero! Hello everyone and welcome to Phonics with Chocolate Chocolate Button. Today we are going to start off with some handwriting warm-up exercises as per usual. Okay, let's get going. Right, we're going to start with hand push. So remember your elbows are 90 degrees up from your hands like that. So you have your nice 90 degree angle there, a 90 degree angle there. And then you're going to push your hands together as hard as you can. Ready? Go. 1, 2, 3, 4. Keep pushing. 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. And release. Oh my goodness. And then we're going to do it again. Shake it out. And ready? Push again. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. 10. Oh my goodness me. Woo! Relax. And then last one. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, and relax. Oh my goodness me, that's good. Okay, now we're going to just put our hands together like that. So similar again, but we're not going to push this time. We're just going to move our thumbs, try and keep the rest of your fingers really still around each other. There we go, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, okay? And then our index fingers, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And then our middle fingers, see if you can just move those. I find it tricky, this one. Just move your index fingers, that's it. Can you see I'm just moving those ones? Okay, and then your ring finger. There we go. I'm doing a little dance. 5. And then your little finger. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. That's it. Fantastic. Right, next. We're going to move our fingers up both pens. I mean, I've got two pens. You might have two pencils, or you might just have one and you can just do one at a time, okay? I'm just going to do it with both to show you with both hands. So you're going to move your fingers up the pen like that, and then you're going to flip it so you can keep moving up. Okay, whoop. And flip. Can you see I'm just using one hand on each pen? There's one hand, no help from the other hand, and then there's my other hand. No help from the other hand. Okay, see how many times you can do that without dropping them as they move up and down your hands, your fingers. As you get better, you might be getting better at just moving them on the tips of your fingers so that your hand is not involved at all. Don't worry if it is initially, but as you get better, as I say, you'll be able to start using just your fingertips. Next up, we're going to do the lazy eight, which is where we move our hands in a figure of eight. Okay, Lucy, can you show them, please?
Sure.
So I'm going to put both hands out in front of me, and I'm going to move them to make the shape of an eight on its side. That's it. And try it with one hand over in the left-hand side of your body. Draw an eight. That's it. And then see if you can draw one with your left hand on the other side of your body, on the right hand side of your body. That's it. And see if you can draw two eights at the same time. Oh, it's tricky. That's it. It's just good to cross over to keep both sides of your brain working and connected with each other. That's it. Right, let's do big hands, little hands. Ready? Big hands, little hands. Oh, good. And ready? Let's see if we can get to 20. 20, 19, 18, 17, 16, 15, 14, 13, 12, 11, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and 0. Oh my goodness me, shake it out. Well done, everyone. You are now warmed up and ready for handwriting. We are going to start off by drawing some straight lines, but be careful because we're going to go over the top of the one we've already done. So we're going to go up, down, up. Okay, up, down, up. Lots and lots of times. Let's try it with our finger first. Up, down, up. Up, down, up. That's right. Okay, let's have a go. Up, down, up. Up, down, up. So you have to go over the line you've just done. It. Okay, and the next one we're going to do is a wiggly line. I'm going to try it with my left hand. Okay, Oh, I need to practice with that left hand, don't I? My goodness. And then the next one, we're going to do the letter C. So we're going to go forwards and backwards and forwards and backwards and forwards and backwards, forwards and backwards, forwards and backwards, forwards and backwards, forwards and backwards. There we go. And now we're going to go and do some up and downs, but not back over each other. So like up, down, up, down, up, down, up, down, up, down, up, down, up. And then one straight line going from left to right. Wow. Nice work, everyone. That is not easy. Pardon? Ruby? Oh, yes, you're absolutely right. Ruby has written to me to ask me if we can do the letter G today. And I said that would be absolutely fine. So we're going to do the letter G today, which makes the sound G. Right, okay, I'm just going to wipe my board and then we'll get going. So the letter G, we're going to go forwards and backwards and up. And down and flick. Okay, show me with your fingers first. Forwards and backwards and up and down and flick. With my left finger, forwards and backwards and up and down and flick. That's it. Let's see if I can do it with both. See if you can do it with both. Forwards and backwards and up and down and flick. Okay, so it's just like the Q we were doing yesterday, but instead of going that way with a pointy bottom to our descender, we're going to go that way with a nice curvy bottom to our descender. Let me show you. So we're going to go forwards and backwards and up and down and flick. Let me see if I can do that with my left hand. So we're going to go forwards and backwards and up and down and flick. My goodness, sorry, that was not very good. Let's see if I can practice again. Forwards and backwards and up and down and flick. That's a bit better. Let me see if I can practice again. It's really good how practice just makes it get better and better. Up and down and flick. There we go. Look, you can see how I'm getting better the more I practice. That's the way it is for you too. Amazing. Right, let me see. Let's do another line. Forwards and backwards and up and down and flick. Forwards and backwards and up and down and flick. Forwards and backwards and up and down and flick. Forwards and backwards and up and down and flick. There we go. I'll just do it one more time with my right hand so that everyone can see from a right-handed point of view. We go forwards and backwards and up and down and flick. There we go. And this one makes the sound... Chocolate, chocolate button. What sound does it make? G. It makes the sound G. The water gurgles down the drain, the water gurgles down the drain, the water gurgles down the drain with a g-g-g-g-g-g. That's it, well done. Right, let's have a go at our handwriting pattern practice session. Let's go. See if you can say the sound before I do. Let's go. Ooh. Ooh. Z. Z. U. U. F. Oh, look. F. U. Few. There were a few cabbages in the shop today. Few. Mmm, lips open. Qua. P. H. O. Mmm. I. Oi. Oo or Ow. O. Th. Or the. Air. Ch. Oh, look. Ch. Air. Chair. Lucy sat on the chair. Oi. Oh. I. Ear. Ah. Eh. Ah. Eh. V. Ow. Or. Or your. E. Y. Or E at the end of a word. A. A. Now, yesterday I had some notes given back to me about yesterday's session, because yesterday I said that this word is often found at the end of a word, for example, in the word fur. But Amani has very correctly pointed out that in the word burger, this er is at the beginning of the, is the first er sound, and then this er sound is the second sound, so it would be b-er-g-er, burger. Okay, so they both make the er sound, but this one is actually in the middle of the word rather than at the end. So I am very sorry if I misled you yesterday. This is sometimes found in the middle of the word, as is this one, actually, to be fair. Okay, so that's just to make clear. And the last one we have is g. We did our
words yesterday in 36 seconds. Let's see if we can beat our score. We're going to use the brown words today. Are you ready? I steady. Go. She. We. Me. So. Come. Oh, some. It's. From. He. Like. Just. Have. Be. Come. Said. That was the last one. Wow-wee, that was amazing. Well done. I think you did that in 34 seconds today. And Lucy was not very good at and quick at putting them up there. So well done. That's amazing. 2 whole seconds quicker. Let's see if we can do it even quicker next week. Brilliant. Okay. We're now going to go and play Countdown. Woo! I know there's no need to explain how to play Countdown to you because we already know. But we're just going to go through a few words before we get started just to help us out. Okay, here we go. D. R. Ow. Dr. Ow. Drown. Drown. Drown means that you sink in the water and you swallow lots of water. Okay, drown. Next word is d. R. D. Dr. I. Drin. Drink. Drink. Ah, drink. Well, we know what drink means. There we go, that's drink. This one, st, I, st, I, sti, stin, stin, stink, stink, stink. Don't sniff people's gym trainers because they stink. Okay, fair enough. Stink. P, p, l, pl, pl, a. Plan, plan. Ooh, like to make a plan. I remember doing that before. Plank, plank. Oh, if you are a pirate, you might ask someone to walk the plank, which is a flat piece of wood, and shoots out of the side of the pirate ship. And then, if someone's been very naughty, then you make them walk the plank, so they have to walk down the edge of the plank and then jump off the other end into the sea. Oh, plank. The next one is th or the. We'll see what it is. Th or the. Tha, than, thank, thank, thank. It's the word thank. And we know about this word, don't we? Because we've written loads of thank you cards in our time in reception. Thank you. So that's how you spell it. Thank. And the next one is the word st. St. A. M. Stamp. Stamp. Stamp, 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 stamp. Stamp means to put your feet down really, really hard. And it's also a little square of sticky paper with the Queen's picture of a picture of the Queen on it, and if you stick it on an envelope, then the post people send your letter for you. Okay, so is our way of paying post people. Okay, there we go. Now, as I understand it, some of you are watching it together with someone else. So you might be watching it with your mummy, or you might be watching this with your sister or your brother. So what I thought we'd do is we'd have a go all together And then you could take it in turns to have a go by yourselves, just to give each other a bit of a practice just by yourselves. Okay, so rather than relying on the other person to say the words before you, or of course they might even put you off, I'm sure no one would put you off, because we're trying to help each other, aren't we, with our learning at the moment. I'm sure we wouldn't be putting people off. But if we were, then we wouldn't do that. We'd just give each other a chance to read it by ourselves, and then we'll pause it, and then you can have a go by yourself, okay, if you rewind it and have another go back. Okay, so I won't even say it the second time, so that you can have a go completely by yourselves, because I think you're getting really, really good at this. I can tell from Leandro's videos that he is getting really good. He beats me most of the time. Okay, so here we go then. An, to, in, the, no, get, not, and, he, to, be, her, she, my, look, are, went, come, some, little, it's, out, there, just, drown, drown, drink, drink, stink, stink, lank, thank, stamp. Oh my goodness. Okay, this time, take it in turns. Just one of you have a go by yourself and see how you get on. I won't even have a go myself. See how you get on without me and without your brother or your sister or your mum or your dad. Okay? Ready? Oh, should we have a quick practice first? Have a quick look. One of you's turn now. Okay, ready, steady, go. How did you get on? Oh my goodness, that was really, really good. I was really impressed. I could hear some really, really good trying. Well done, everyone. Now, if you've got someone else there with you, now, thank you for being patient. It can be your turn and you can have a go by just rewinding this little bit of video and then pressing play again, and it can be your turn and you can see who got the most words. Maybe you both got all of them, who knows? Okay, fantastic. Right. Let's move on. Okay, everyone, are you ready for our quick write? There is something for everyone here, so just make sure that you've got your whiteboard and your whiteboard pen and your pencil and your paper ready so that we can get started, because number one is coming up now. Number one is the word trust. Trust. See how many sounds it's got. T, r, a, s, t, trust. Five sounds, and in fact, five letters. T, r, a, s, t, trust. Trust. If you trust someone, then it means that you believe everything that they say. Trust. Trust. Number two is the word brand. Brand. We had that one on Monday, didn't we? B-R-A-N-D. Brand. B-R-A-N-D. Brand. Five letters, five sounds. Brand. And you remember it had lots of different meanings. Like sometimes it's a way of showing that a horse or a cow or something belongs to you. And sometimes it's a way of selling your product. Brand. Number three is the word frost. F-R-O-S-T. Frost. Frost. F-R-O-S-T. Frost. Again, 5 letters and 5 sounds. Nice and easy. And frost is, we actually talked about it the other day, but I don't think we had to spell it the other day. Frost is when the dew on the grass gets so, so cold that it turns to ice. That's called frost. Frost. And number 4 is the word blend. Blend. B-L-E-N-D. Blend. Blend. Blend means to mix together into a liquid. Blend. It also means in phonics that we put all our sounds together to make a word. So if we said k-at, blending would be cat. That's it. Blend. I think maybe we did have that the other day. Blend. The next one is the number 5, and it is the word grasp. Grasp. G-r-a-s-p. Grasp. Now, in this one, the R sound on this finger, g-r-r, that one there, the R sound, I say R, but Shirley would say ah. So that gives you a clue of how to spell it. G-r-a-s-p, grasp. Okay, so if you were from Yorkshire, you would say grasp. And if you're American as well, you might say grasp. Okay, so think about how an American would say it or how Shirley would say it. I'm not very good at doing impressions of Shirley, as you know. But ah is the sound. G-r-a-s-p. Grasp. But the way I say it, is grasp. And it means to catch hold of something and hold it tight. Grasp. It could also mean to understand. To grasp a concept would mean that you finally understood it. Grasp. The next one is bland. Bland. B-L-A-N-D. Bland. Bland. B-L-A-N-D. Bland. And remember, it's the B sound, as you can see up there. B, not D. Bland. Actually, it ends with a D and starts with a B. Bland. Bland. And bland means that it doesn't really give you any excitement, I suppose. So if maybe you might describe a song as being a bit bland, it wasn't very exciting as a song, wasn't a very fun song. Or sometimes you might say food is a bit bland, you can't really taste it. It's a bland kind of taste, there's nothing really tasty in it. Or you might say a piece of artwork or a colour is a bit bland. There's nothing exciting, nothing making you go, oh wow, about it. Bland. Okay, the next one is the word growl. Growl. We've got g-r-ow-l. So this time only 4 sounds, but there are 5 letters because the ow sound is the one spelled with an O-W. G-r-owl. Growl. It's actually got the word owl hidden inside it. Growl. And we know what growl means because bears do it. They go grrr, grrr. And that's a growl. Can you do a growl? Grrr. That's it. Growl. The next one is the word spoon. Spoon. S-p-oon. Spoon. Again, 4 sounds, 5 letters, because the oo sound, as we know, is spelled with double O. Spoon. 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 I eat my cereal in the breakfast at breakfast time with a spoon. Spoon. The next word is the word swim. 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 I know Elizabeth loves to swim because I went to watch her swimming lesson when I went to stay with her at the weekend. Swim. S-w-i-m. Swim. The next ones are the ones that we've been practicing this week. So let's see how you get on. So we are on number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Number 10 is the word were. Were. Don't forget that E on the end. Were. Number 11 is the word there. There. Look over there. Number 12 is the word little. 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 Number 13 is the word one. Oh my goodness, every single day I've forgotten to put this at number one. Silly me. Oh dear. Anyone would think I'd be thinking about something else, but no, all the time forgetting this. One. The number one. Number 14 is the word said. Said. We practiced that loads before the holidays. I wonder if you can remember how to spell it now. Said. That's it, said. And the next one is the word they. They. They all went back to school and had a lovely time in the playground playing with all of their friends and Shirley and Cam and Lucy. They. Oh, I hope it's soon. They. And the next one is all. All. Not one, not two, not three, not four, but all of the children had a lovely day. All. And the last one is the word are. Are. Just like we've been practicing all week, the word are. Are. Fantastic. Well done, everyone. That is all our quick write words for today. So let's have a little look and see how we've got on. Don't worry if you haven't got them all right. We are here to learn, and that is the whole point. Okay, see you in a second. Well done, everybody. My goodness, what a lot of spellings. I didn't realise just how many there were going to be. Sorry about that. Whoops. Okay. Now we have, because it's Friday, Fish and Chips Friday, Friday, Fish and Chips Friday, Friday, woo. We are going to do shared reading, because that is what we do on a Friday at the end of phonics. So we have a lovely book, which I don't think we've read before altogether, and it is called My... Here we go. Which spells my, as we've been learning. My, brother, my brother, my brother, seen. It does look like seen, Jockle Jockle Button. You've read that out exactly right, except that we pronounce that Sean. Okay, so it's called My Brother Sean. That's just how you spell Sean. Oh, okay. And it's by Petronella Breenberg. Breenberg. Oh, look, there's the UR sound in the middle of the word, just like Amani said. By Petronella Breenberg, with illustrations, which means pictures, with illustrations by Errol Lloyd. And it is published by, look, another bird as a publisher. My goodness, Picture Puffins. This is Picture Puffins, so thank you to Petronella Breenberg, Errol Lloyd and Picture Puffins for letting us read the story today, because we can't read it in our normal phonics lesson together. Okay, here we go. Oh, look, that must be Sean, do you think? I think you're probably right. Let's see what happens in this. Oh, lovely bit of orange there. Here we go. My Brother Sean by Petronella Breenberg, with illustrations by Errol Lloyd. Look. Lovely pictures, aren't they? Puffin Books. Look, he's looking out of the window, look. Sean always, it must be always, Sean always wanted, Sean always wanted to go to, Sean always wanted to go to school. Sean always wanted to go to school. Oh, look. I wonder why he can't go to school. Same as us. I really want to go to school, but I can't. Then one... Oh, there's the word one. We've been learning that this week. Then one day... Then one day, mum and me took. Then one day, mum and me took him to the nursery. Then one day, mum and me took him to the nursery. Oh, look, there's that U-R-er sound in the middle of the word again, just like Hermione said. Oh, dear. Lucy did forget, didn't she? She did. I thought he wanted to go to nursery. Look. Oh, my goodness. Sean cried. Oh, no. Poor Sean. Look at the other little girls and boys. Oh, Look, Nazim, there's a train set. My goodness, I think it looks really fun, that nursery. Poor Sean. It's a shock, isn't it, having to go back to school suddenly, or to go to school. At first, he was, chocolate button, haha, sorry, was, he was only shy. At first, he was only shy. Oh, look. If you're shy, it means that you're a bit nervous of other people and you don't know what to say to them. You're feeling a bit unclear about how to be friends with people. You want them to like you. When it was time for us to say goodbye, Sean cried. Oh dear, poor Sean. Look, all the other little girls and boys are watching him crying. Oh dear. Poor Sean. The teacher was chocolate button. was kind. Oh, we did that this week, didn't we? It's kind. The teacher was kind. We've, which is short for we have, we've got lots of nice kids. We've got lots of nice kids, said the kind teacher to Sean. Look at them all. They all look nice and kind and friendly, don't they? All playing lots of different games. Look, Sean's doing some painting. It's just like our reception class. We've got lots of nice, kind children as well, haven't we? And lots of toys. And lots of toys, said Mum. Look at them go. Look, they've got scooters like us, and bikes, and all sorts of fun things. Look, they've even got a car. Wow-wee, I wish we had a car. So do I. That looks really fun. And they've got a swing too, I said. And they've got a swing too, I said. Oh, so fun. I love a good swing.